One eye look to the left, another eye look to the right. We have to have a clear focus and vision in our life. The Bible says that when we have good spiritual eyes and see the things of God in the right way, our whole life, our whole body will be full of light. Light gives health. Darkness gives sickness. When our life is so full of light, the sickness cannot be there. And we're going to be healed quickly. Light and darkness cannot be together. When you walk into the room full of light, there's no darkness. When you walk into the room so dark, there's no light. So you have to choose whether your life is going to be full of light or your life is going to be full of darkness. I want my whole body to be full of light so that I can stay healthy and I can stay in the way of God. Let's look at another scripture about light. In Malachi chapter 4 verse 2, the Bible says, "But to you who fear my name, the Son," capital S-U-N. Actually, this is talking about Jesus Christ. "The Son of righteousness shall arise with healing in his wings. And you shall go out and grow fat like stall-fed calf." You will be so full of anointing of God. The Bible talks about Jesus as the Son, capital S-U-N, of righteousness. And when the sun comes up, the light comes as well. When you have Jesus and his word in your life, you have your eye focused on Jesus and on his word, the light comes in. And what happened to you? The Bible said that when the light is filled in your life, when your life is so filled with the light, you're going to have righteousness. Light produces righteousness. But darkness produces sin. Not only that, the light produces health. The Bible says with healing in his wings. When the light of Jesus show up, when the word of God is working in our life, we will have good health and healing. But darkness will produce sickness. Darkness and light cannot be together. Now it's our choice whether we want the Son of Righteousness to be in our life. We want the light of God to be in our life or not. It's our choice. You all make choice. I just teach you, but you make choice yourself. For me, I want the light of God to be in my life so that I can have righteousness and light and life and medicine and healing and good divine health and long life. The Greek word for the word focus and single focus can mean also simplicity and sincerity. What the Word of God tried to say is that when our spiritual eyes are focused on the Word, it means that we read and listen to the Word of God with a simple heart, with the sincerity of heart. Everyone says simple. Why? Well, I need to talk about this. This message will be so easy in a third world country because people don't think too much. They just receive the word, boom, thing happened in their life, miracle happened. Because they receive the word in a simple way. But in the Western country, people are very clever, have high education. They think that they're smarter than God. People are so philosophical and very profound in their thinking. People are very sophisticated. And rationalization is in their mind. So teaching the Word of God to the Western and civilized country is quite tough. Because people are going to come to God and argue with their prejudice and preconception and their smartness. They don't come to the Word of God with the simplicity of heart or with the sincerity of heart. They will come and argue with God. I don't believe that. I'm too clever. I know too much. They have prejudice and preconceptions. And not only that, many people come to God with rationalization. What does it mean, rationalization? It means that I'm going to come up with a reason to argue with God what's going on in the Word of God there. You say that, no, but my logic doesn't say that way. So that I don't agree. They don't come to God with simplicity of heart. Another enemy of the simplicity of heart is we call sophistication. Sometimes preacher can make the word of God so complicated to the point that the members sit there and, what? I don't understand what you're talking about. So complicated, sophisticated. No, actually the word of God is so simple. We need to take the word of God the way it is written. Whatever it say, take it as meaning what it say. Don't try to twist it. Don't try to make it too complicated. Don't try to use your clever mind to massage and to do something to change the word of God. Just come to God with a simple mind, have a simplicity of the heart, and receive what God say. In the eyes of the world, what God say is like a pure nonsense. God say, receive my word, you'll be healed. And people say, no way, no way. You receive the word of God and you're going to be healed. No way, no way. This is nonsense. This is ridiculous. If you think that you are more clever than the Bible, you're going to stay clever, but stay sick. But if you are willing to choose a simple message of the word of God, you will be healed. Which one do you want to choose? I want to choose simple, but be healed. Amen. Many years ago, when I encountered the file of God and brought the file of God to the church, a lot of people left this church and shook their head and said, this guy is crazy. The pastor brought the file of God to the church. They all think like, I'm crazy, I'm foolish to do this because a member going to leave the church, people going to walk away. You need to do entertainment. You cannot do this. The file of God moving. But I stick with the word, the simplicity. The file of God, the file of God. And we can keep people in good health better than without the file of God. We can keep the marriage better than without the file of God. I rather keep the marriage, rather keep people in good health than try to be too sophisticated. I don't want my member to go to see psychiatrists and to see doctor. I want them to be healed and simple before the Lord. Amen? This is the problem. We are living in the world. We are trained by the world system. And many times the world system say what we believe is foolish in their eyes. 1 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 25. The foolishness of God is wiser than men. And the weakness of God is stronger than men. The Apostle Paul talked about the cross. In his time, dying on the cross is the foolish thing. It's the weakest thing to do. To go to the cross and die on the cross? This is stupid. This is foolish. You die on the cross? In the eyes of the world, to go to the cross is a foolish thing and weak thing. But God say, my foolish thing is more wiser than the wisdom of the world. And my weak things is stronger than the strength of the world. And today, because Jesus died on the cross, millions of people are saved, set free, and delivered. If you don't believe it, I'm sorry. I have my first-hand experience that what Jesus did for me on the cross really changed my life. I become a new man. God really blessed me and take care of me. What he did on the cross really changed my life. It's the strength and it's the wisdom of God. Amen? Amen? How many people want the wisdom of God? How many people say, I'd rather choose the strength of God, not the strength of the world? I'd rather choose the strength of God. Paul said in 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 18, let no one deceive himself. If anyone among you seems to be wise in this age or in the eyes of the world, let him become a fool that he may become wiser. In order to receive the word of God into our eyes, the focus eyes, we need to be humble. The way of the world will say to us, hey, you don't need God. You can save yourself. You can help yourself. But if you say, I want the way of God, I need to be humble. We need to lay aside the wisdom of the world and receive the wisdom of God, which is foolish in the eyes of the world. I'm going to make a conclusion here.